Welcome to another 60 Seconds in Thailand. Today, a very important and very timely update. Since all the way back on March 26, when the big lockdown began, those foreigners who were stuck in Thailand at the time were offered visa amnesty. They've been enjoying this amnesty ever since, but it's set to expire at the end of this week on September 26th. Thailand Immigration has issued a warning for everyone on this program to make sure to update your visa status before the deadline. Those currently under amnesty have two choices: leave the country or extend your visa. Beginning September 27th, normal overstay penalties will begin to be enforced again. If you don't know, the penalty for overstaying your visa in Thailand starts with a fine of 500 baht per day, up to a maximum of 20,000 baht. But those on an overstay of more than 90 days will face a one-year ban from re-entering Thailand. And those who have overstayed their visa for more than 1 year would face a three-year ban. Keep in mind, these penalties are only for those that voluntarily surrender themselves. If immigration has to come and find you, then the penalties go up dramatically. It's estimated that there are still 150,000 people still under this visa amnesty. So be prepared for some long waits at the immigration office this weekend. In fact, reports out of Phuket are saying that the immigration office there is already getting overwhelmed. And if you leave it until this Friday, I wouldn't want to be in your shoes. Also important to note that this isn't just for tourists. Those under a retirement visa, a marriage visa, a visa based on parenting a Thai child, an education visa, any visa that has expired during the amnesty needs to be dealt with this week. There's other news, and it's related to the STV, or the special tourist visa. The last report on this channel detailed exactly what the qualification measurements are, but the Thai government is getting set to launch this imminently with a twist. They're now saying that Bangkok will be the primary destination of the first wave of tourists. If you're overseas and looking to come to Thailand, the recommendation is that you contact an overseas office of the TAT, the Tourism Authority of Thailand, and begin the inquiry process. Those that are approved will be allowed entry on special charter flights. They're saying that there'll be a maximum of 100 tourists per flight and a maximum of 3 flights per week.
We interrupt this newscast with special breaking news. We're going to take you to the studio now.
We're on now. How's my hair? Is it newscaster worthy? Oh, screw it, we'll do it live.
Hello everyone, we do have breaking news from back in the studio. As we were putting together this report, the Thai government issued detailed step-by-step instructions on how you can obtain this special tourist visa. We'll run through each step now, so consider this the definitive video on how to actually get tourism status in Thailand today. First, those interested in acquiring an STV must formally declare their intent with an agency in your country of origin. The agency must be approved by Thai authorities, and after you make contact, the Tourism Authority of Thailand, or TAT, will liaise with that agency to provide them the list of required documents. The initial documents to be completed include your choice of facility or ASQ that you intend to spend your 14-day quarantine. They also include your choice for accommodation after your quarantine ends. On top of this, you'll need to provide proof that you have health coverage in the amount of $100,000. You'll also need to provide your charter flight or private jet details. Once complete, these documents will be sent to the Ministry of Foreign Affairs here in Thailand, and if approved, they will issue a Certificate of Entry, or COE. The Ministry of Foreign Affairs will then reach out to the Thai embassy in the applicant's country of origin. The applicant can then go to their local Thai embassy and collect the SPV and the COE at the same time as providing the remaining required documents. These documents include proof of your final reservation, along with proof of payment, a fit to fly certificate, and a negative COVID-19 test that has been taken within 72 hours of your departure date. Upon arrival in Thailand, another COVID test will be administered. Those testing positive will be sent immediately to a local hospital for treatment. Those testing negative will then receive the final STV. Special tourist visa. Then, directly from the airport, visitors will begin their 14-day quarantine at their facility of choice. Upon completion of the 14-day quarantine, visitors will be allowed to travel freely throughout the kingdom using a special mobile phone application that tracks all of your destinations. This has been your breaking news. They plan to see how it goes during the first month and then hopefully ramp up from there. Make no mistake, this first program is not aimed at all of the short-term vacation seekers out there. This is aimed at long-term tourists only. And yes, it'll probably be somewhat expensive, but this is a necessary stepping stone in getting the country opened again and ultimately allowing those short-term visitors in. I've had so many comments on previous videos in this series complaining about this isn't for me. What good does this do me? This is only for rich people. Well, as I said, you have to start somewhere, and without this initial stepping stone, we'll never get to those other categories of traveler. So I, for one, think that this program should be applauded. I hope that it's very successful in both attracting the first wave of tourists while also keeping everyone in the nation safe from the COVID virus. There seems to be more talk of Scandinavian countries being the first target for the Thai government to try and attract these tourists from. Nothing's finalized there yet, so be sure to subscribe to this channel, and I promise to keep you updated every step of the way. Finally, I'm back in Bangkok now, but don't worry, for those of you expecting this video to be part 3 in the My Favorite Beach in Thailand series, that one's coming tomorrow. For those of you who haven't seen parts 1 and 2, here, I'll leave a